Hey there, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily, and I create mostly Salesforce tutorials with some other tutorials about related software. Today, we're going to be covering how to create a vertical bar chart component within a Salesforce dashboard. So, first things first, make sure that you can see the dashboarding tab. If you cannot, you can also come over here to the 3x3 and search for dashboards, and you can click on that item and it'll take you to the same place. From here, you can go to test dashboard or click new dashboard. I'm going to click test dashboard because I've already created one. I'm going to hit edit, and from here, I'm going to click new component. Here is where we are going to choose our source report. So the source report dictates what information you are able to visualize within a dashboard. So you do need to create this before, and I am in the middle of a series on reporting within Salesforce. So if you want to know how to create a source report, then go ahead and watch that video, and I'll have some linked down below. I'm going to click on the matrix report. For the vertical bar chart, you need to have either a grouping of columns or a grouping of rows on your source report to be able to create this type of component. So here I am on the add component, and we're going to choose the different properties of it. So I'm going to select vertical bar chart, and as you can see, we have the vertical bar chart. I'm going to change it to from create a by to account name on the x-axis, and have record count stay on the y-axis. We can display our units as a shortened number and show values. Those are a few different options. We could display the full number, hundreds, thousands, really whatever's going to help you display your information the best or visualize it the best. Feel free to play around with these settings. I'm going to have the y-axis range be automatic. So if you wanted this to show different numbers here, let's say you wanted the middle bound to be 10 and you wanted the upper bound to be 20 because that's your goal, then you are able to do that. We can sort by created by and record count. We can also then sort it by a different criteria. We can add a custom link. We can show or choose the number of the maximum groups displayed, and we can change the title of it. I highly recommend that you do. It's going to default to the source report title. So I'm going to have this be named vertical bar chart, just so then it's a little easier for us. We do have the option of adding a subtitle. I don't think it's necessary, but it might help those who are viewing your dashboard to gain a little bit of extra context. We can also add a footer. We can change around the legend position. So if I wanted to put it on the bottom to have the numbers viewed a little bit better, you can do that. And then we can change the theme from light to dark or dark to light. Click add. And then it looks like it's hiding from me. We can move this around. And we can put this wherever we want within our dashboard. So I'm going to click save and done, and it'll take us to be able to view our dashboard now. And we have options here to refresh, edit, subscribe, click the caret, download, save as, create a new dashboard, or delete. If we go down and we see this little link next to view report, it'll take us to our source report where we can inspect the different filters and data as it is raw. I'm going to click back. And that is how you create a vertical bar chart component within a Salesforce dashboard. This is a part of a larger series I am doing on my channel on Salesforce reporting. So if you want to learn more about reporting and dashboards within Salesforce, click the first link down in the description. If this was helpful, hit the like button, subscribe if you're feeling generous, and I will catch you in the next one.